Brooklyn. City leaders say it'll be one that's more cost efficient than the old one, but it won't be in the same location. City leaders say it'll be in a part of town where there are more people living within walking distance.
If you dig deep into Spartanburg's north side,
planting tomatoes,
you'll find small signs of hard work from longtime homeowners like this man.
50-something years.
This area, which includes big names like Spartanburg Regional and Wofford College, has history.
People used to walk to the mill, but they've done away with the mill.
VCOM, the new medical school, built where the mill once stood, jump-starting growth over here. The Healthy Food Hub, which will be the new home of the farmers market and a culinary arts program, is next in line.
We've got folks and institutions that are going to be here a long time and the opportunity to build a really, truly world-class neighborhood.
Spartanburg's assistant city manager, Chris Story, says the next step is building a state-of-the-art rec center, which will have the same name as the soon-to-close T.K.Gregg Center.
Yeah, be a great thing.
It seems to be a welcomed idea in an area hungry for revitalization.
Landlords don't want to do this, and they want all the rent, but don't want to spend no money. They'd rather board them up.
That's taken care of too, says Story.
The Northside Development Corporation is a local nonprofit that's been formed under the leadership of our former mayor, Bill Barnett.
The nonprofit group is working on doing something with these battered, beaten, and boarded up houses.
Anything to help the community is great.
Sprucing up this part of town, which is a stone's throw from downtown, will take years, but people who live here are ready to watch the plan grow into reality.
Oh yeah, be a whole lot better.
And you may remember that there was also talk of closing the popular swim center, but city leaders say that will stay open for at least another year to give them time to find partners or funding for that location. Mike McCormick, WIFF News 4, live tonight in Spartanburg.